bit just like your breeches, scholar lad.
I beg your pardon?
Nothing. I said nothing.
Hush, Itumak. We'll just wait a little longer. Easy, Itumak. It's not him. Short version? I'm looking for a very, very old friend. I'm not sure what skin he's wearing now, but I'll know him when I see him. That's what I heard. Of course, the man who told me so was carrying a staff he claimed was made from dragon bone, but I know Whitewood when I see it. That should have been my first clue, but I had to try something. The long version. Here we go. I'm from an island to the far south called Nasitak. I came here looking for a village elder, a man we knew as Persok. I'm a hunter back home, so tracking someone wouldn't normally be a problem. But Persok's trail is cold, to say the least. That about sums it up. So I keep reminding myself. Still, it would be nice if important duties came with clearer instructions. Cute, isn't it? It belonged to Persok. Before he returned to the wheel, he left a splinter of his soul in it. Something to help us find him later. When I left Nasitak, it was completely dark inside. But as I've gotten closer to Persok, it's glowed steadily brighter. Since I've reached the Deerwood, however, it's gotten hard to read. Some days it flickers and goes dark. Others it shines nice and bright for a few hours. But most of the time, it looks just like this. I can tell you what I won't do again. Rely on miracle peddlers. It was some so-called watcher who sent me to this crossroads in the middle of nowhere in the first place. I was on my way out of the Balmarsh when I heard talk of a traveling mystic who could supposedly see souls. I knew it was a long shot, but what did I have to lose? I went to see this fellow and gave him the Audra figurine. He made a big show of moaning and rolling his eyes, and after I'd given him 5 golden dukes to lift the shroud, he told me to seek the crossroads in the field between the wolf's lair and the twining trees. He thought he was being vague, but I know the area well enough to recognize that he meant this place, right between Defiance Bay and Twin Elms. I had a bad taste in my mouth, but my coin was spent and I'd already left an arrow in his knapsack as a friendly warning. Told him I'd come back and leave him with another if it turned out he was giving me the runaround. I've been here a week now. Guess he had the last laugh after all. Why? You expect me to believe that? After the story I just told you? Fine. But if you try to run, just remember that my arrows are faster. What are you talking about? What just happened? You realize I've got no coin to give you, even if I did believe you. And if this is your idea of a joke, you may be stuck with me for a while. Lead the way.
Defiance Bay, the city at the heart of the Deerwoods Revolution, now seems on the brink of another. Refugees line the streets, homeless and hungry, displaced by Whitewind's legacy, hoping for relief within the city walls, and finding none. Dissidents congregate to protest and to heckle, calling for an end to Enomancy and the ouster of their duke. The city's militiamen cast fearful looks as they patrol the streets, their hands trembling at the hilts of their weapons. The capital of a country that had not long ago incinerated a god now appears to be a spark away from sharing the deity's fate.
The City of Defiance, crown jewel of the Deerwood, if you ask the locals.
Thank you.
Is this the old church you were looking for?
Praise to the exiled queen. May her crown be restored and her justice prevail. Come to pay your respects to the queen that was. Lord Ardwellan Rugford III, am pleased to make your acquaintance. I came to the Deerwood on one of the first ships from Adia, and unlike the yokels and hut dwellers around here, I still keep to the old ways. And so you did. These savage colonists may have burned it down, but worship of the Oathbinder is alive and well. These stairs lead to the main sanctum. These stairs, of course. The sanctum was always below ground, adjacent to the catacombs, so it wasn't destroyed by the fires. There are various entrances throughout Defiance Bay, but I dare say the easiest to reach is in Copper Lane. I haven't been to that part of town in ages, but as I recall, it's somewhere near the southern gate. Worshipping Woodica, the exiled queen and oathbinder. I come every day to offer my devotion. I'd love nothing more than to book passage back to Adia, but it is my Emperor's wish that I serve in these barbaric lands. And so I do. A queen among the gods. She oversees laws and oaths. Everything has a rightful place, and Woodica watches over them all. Of course, not everyone accepts this. Even among the other gods, her authority is questioned. But Woodica is also goddess of memory and vengeance. And she remembers. She'll remember every slight and trespass when she reclaims her throne. I beg your pardon? Is this some sort of joke where you come from? A madhouse. That's what this town really needs.
Grave Dalfila Dili.
I'll teach you.
I'm here. Ready, Watcher.
Following your lead.
How may I help?
Ready, Watcher.
I?
Brave Dalfilar.
I'll teach you a lesson!
That's not very helpful.
No! Hang on!
Thank you.
not hear the...
Dawn!
That's not very good.
Does not believe.
Sure.
How may I help? How may I help?
Ready, Watcher.
Hi? Thank you.
Scar.
I'll see you pay for that!
me.
Be strong, Ella!
Come on! Not like that! Let's cut out for this now!
You are from Kratoon, my boy. A remarkable city. Truly one of the most impressive we have encountered outside of our own. Many exceptional people who have joined our cause come from Kratoon. What made you decide to join our order? Remember never to be discouraged by those who cling to their beliefs. They are worthy of our pity, not our scorn. Are you ready to take the oath? To spread the word of the gods to the lost and heathen?
Nice and quiet.
Good day to you.
I'll have it in no time. I'll see what I can do.
Back, you Claude! Those hooded fiends are not to be trusted!
I'll have it in no time.